Hi friends, welcome to this class. In previous classes, as we have discussed about gravimetry, what is gravimetry we have discussed, that is introduction class, followed by preparation of solution we have discussed, and next it is precipitation of solution. Next we discussed about what errors in precipitation, what kind of errors, co-precipitation, post-precipitation, and how to reduce them, those things we have discussed. And what else? Preparation, precipitation, and also we have discussed about this digestion. And we have discussed about washing of this precipitate, and also how to select this washing liquid we have discussed. If we select what wrong washing liquid, what happens, that thing also I have explained. And how this digestion helps, how it keeps this Q value less, S value more, so RSS value will be less, that thing. This formula, it is very important. RSS is equal to Q minus S divided by S. This thing you should know, right? These are all the things we have discussed. So in this class, let us discuss about, after washing, what we do? Drying and igniting. See, what I did, I got this precipitate, Fe, what was the precipitate? My precipitate was FeOH thrice into EXH2. This was the precipitated, and I washed it, I got the pure FeOH thrice into XH2. So along with filter paper, I will take it, I will keep it for drying. I keep some oven here like this, and I will supply heat so that this precipitate breaks. I will see some cracks on this precipitate on filter paper. Once it is dried completely, I will take this and I will have two kind of crucible. One is, this is a silica crucible. Another one will be like this. This is a G4 crucible, we call it. This silica crucible will be used for inorganic compounds. This is used for, most of the times used for inorganic compounds. Why inorganic? Because here we supply heat which is more than 200 degree Celsius. We supply heat. Whereas G4 crucible, this is for organic compounds like nickel DMG or copper cyanide, nickel DMG complex or copper cyanide complex. For this we use this G4 crucible. See here, as we know, these organic compounds like DMG is there, no? If we increase the heat, if we heat them, they will decompose only at, see here, this DMG, let us see, it will decompose at 130 to 140 degrees Celsius. If I supply more than this heat, it will decompose. So we won't get nickel DMG complex. This DMG will go into carbon dioxide and water, so it will decompose. So what we do, for this I will maintain only 110 degree Celsius. Why 110 degree Celsius? I have used water as a washing liquid. So water boiling point is 100 degree Celsius. So water will be removed out completely. So I will get at 110 to 120 degree Celsius, I will get pure nickel DMG complex. So we see what is the nature of that, then we go for drying or igniting. And also I told about, this is all about drying. And also see this one, where is this PPT? Its composition is not known. How many number of water molecules are there, that thing I don't know. So, and also it is inorganic compound. So I took that filter paper, I made into a small like a ball, and I dropped here, and I started igniting more than 200 degrees Celsius. So what happened? that filter paper, about filter paper I have told, those filter papers are ashless filter papers. They will give ash, no doubt. They won't give 100% ashless. They will give little bit of ash, and that weight will be very less than milligrams, right? Very less than milligram. So this won't count in the error, right? So this filter paper we use. And also see here, this is filter paper and I am supplying more heat. So what happened? This compound converted to, this process is called igniting. This process is called igniting. This compound is converted to stable form. What stable form? Fe2O3. This is the stable form. But whereas here, nickel DMG complex is the stable form. But it has got water, right? So I am heating at 110 to 120 degrees Celsius. So that water will be removed and I will get pure nickel DMG complex. This is about drying and igniting. If I supply 150 degrees Celsius, this nickel DMG complex will decompose. This DMG may go as water and carbon dioxide, right? This is all about drying and igniting. So let us discuss about what is the difference between this organic and inorganic, precipitants, right? So let us discuss about this organic precipitation, how it occurs. See here, organic precipitants, or I can use precipitating agent. I can use the name organic precipitating agent or precipitants. See, what are the organic precipitants? Thiocyanide is there. It makes complex of copper as copper thiocyanide. And DMG is there. It makes complex of nickel DMG. Nickel DMG. And also one more oxime is there. Oxime. It makes, I think, aluminium oxime complex. Just you see whether it makes complex with aluminium or not. I hope it makes complex with aluminium. So cyanide, DMG, one more oxalate, oxalic acid, you know, oxalate. This will make a complex of calcium oxalate, right? Calcium with calcium oxalate. This makes complex with calcium. If not so, you please check your book. I think oxalate will make complex with calcium and this oxime with aluminium. Just once you check. These are the organic precipitants. Let me give the structure. DMG structure I have explained. Thiocyanide, no need. Thiocyanide means SC triple bond N. This is the structure of thiocyanide. This oxime. Oxime is something like this here. This is oxime. This is the structure of oxime. 8 hydroxyquinoline. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In general, we call it as oxime, but it is 8 hydroxyquinoline. This compound is quinoline, but at 8th position hydroxide group is attached, so 8 hydroxyquinoline. And the structure for oxalate, we know oxalic acid, COOH. If I remove this H, I will get negative charge on both the oxygen. So it is bidentate ligand. Bidentate means it can attack the compound in both the directions. See, this is calcium, so it can attack like this. Just to check whether this will make complex with aluminium or calcium, that you need to check, because I didn't see it, so you please check it, right? So drying end, and I was telling what is the merits and demerits of this organic precipitant. The merit of this organic precipitant is, see, nickel DMG, the structure will be like this. Nickel here, this one structure like this. So its molecular weight will be more. One thing, its merit. Since molecular weight of these complexes will be more, so error of weighing will be less. So error is less. So this is one merit. And second merit. See, nickel solution is green in color, right? But nickel DMG complex is reddish in color, bright red. So even small amount of nickel is present, then also it gives dark color, that is reddish. So color, this is the second advantage. Color, if we get color, we can easily tell that it has found nickel DMG complex, right? This is second merit of this organic precipitant. And the third merit is, here we can use water as the washing liquid. Why water? Because it is not going to ionize this organic precipitant. This is third merit. And the fourth merit is, this organic, this is all about, these are selective. These are very selective. They won't precipitate all the elements, but only selected elements are precipitated. This is the fourth merit. So high molecular weight, less error, weighing error, more color, more selective, water can be used, so it becomes cheap. Water, everywhere we find water, no? So it becomes cheap to carry out this reaction. But demerits also are there. The demerit is, you have got this nickel DMG complex in a beaker, right? If you want to transfer it, you will get a lot of trouble, because this nickel DMG will creep. It creeps on the wall of this beaker. It won't come out as easily. It creeps on the wall of the beaker. Again, you need to wash. Then also no 100% transfer will be there. Little red color will be remaining of this on this beaker. But you need to transfer everything, 100% transfer, so that you can get correct calculation, right? So one is creeping, that is the demerit. And second demerit is, these will decompose. If we increase igniting or drying for more degree Celsius, these will decompose into carbon dioxide and water. That is the second demerit. And the third one is, it has got one more demerit. One more demerit is post precipitation. Post precipitation means, if we keep it for a long time, this precipitant in solution with mother liquor and this complex, if we keep these precipitants for a long time, these precipitants will settle on these complexes. So molecular weight will increase, so error. So it adds up the error. These are the three. One is creeping, second one is post precipitation, and third one is decomposition at higher degree Celsius. And see, I told, oxygen will make precipitate with Al3+, no doubt. And this with calcium, let me check. If I had written here, no, sorry, I have not written, I think. This oxalate is there, no? It makes precipitate with this calcium, and one more precipitate, sulfate, SO4-2-, it makes precipitate with barium-2+ to form BaSO4. This is white precipitate. These are all the organic precipitants and merits and demerits of organic precipitant. And also I will discuss about drying and igniting. In next class, I will come with few problems so that we will see the next step. That is, after drying and igniting, the next step is calculation. Till then, take care and have a great day.